Hello everyone, welcome to Get 100 Marks. In today's class, we are going to discuss about network topology. There are different types of network topology. Let's start understanding what is star network. The most common network topology is laid out so every node in the network is directly connected to one central hub via coaxial, twisted pair or fiber optic cable. From diagram, you can make out every other systems in the network is connected to the central hub or a central server. The connection is made through either fiber optic cable or a twisted pair cable or a coaxial cable. The central hub acts as a server and it manages the complete transaction. Information sent from any node on the network must pass through the central one to reach its destination. If say system A or system 1 is passing the information to the hub, and if the system 1 is intended to pass the information to system 4, it has to pass through via only the central hub. And the central hub also serves as a repeater which helps prevent data loss. Additionally, devices can be added, removed and modified without taking the entire network offline. In case of addition of new system is required into the network, it can be directly connected to the hub. There is no need of dismantling the complete network and redoing it. And now let's understand what is bus topology. A bus topology orients all the devices on the network along a single cable, running in a single direction from one end of the network to the other, which is why it's sometimes called a line topology or a backbone topology. This network involves a simple arrangement wherein all the systems are connected through a single line which is passing from one end to the other end. Now let's talk about ring topology. Here the nodes are arranged in a ring format. Nodes here denotes to the systems. The systems or any other devices which are connected to the network are arranged in a circular form. The data can travel through the ring network in either one direction or in both directions. This is the unique speciality of ring topology compared to that of a star and bus. Whereas in star and bus, only in one direction the information can pass through. But when it comes through ring topology, the information can pass in two different directions. Packets are the data which travel along the circle, moving through each of the intermediate nodes until they arrive at their destination. Here, unlike bus or a star topology, the information cannot be sent via a central hub or it passes through the line, whereas here it passes through all the system in the ring and reaches the destination. Only one station on the network is permitted to send data at a time. Similar to star and bus topology, even in ring topology, only one system can operate at a time in the network. Now let's talk about tree topology. A tree topology has a parent-child hierarchy to how the nodes are connected. Here, the secondary hub is called as a parent, whereas the other subdivisions are called as child. This is why it is called as a parent-child hierarchy. Those connected to the central hub are linearly connected to the other nodes. So two connected nodes only share one mutual connection. So these two secondary hubs shares only one mutual connection with the central hub, whereas the information passed down from secondary hub to the other systems in the network is also sharing a mutual connection. Because the tree topology structure is both extremely flexible and scalable, it's often used for wide area networks to support many spread out devices. When you have your systems are spread out across the location, the best topology to be used is the tree topology. Next, we are discuss about mesh topology. A mesh topology is an intricate and an elaborate structure of point-to-point connection where the nodes are interconnected. Mesh networks can be full or partially mesh. In the sense, all the other systems could be completely interconnected with each other, or only few systems can be interconnected. The weblet structure of mesh topology offers two different methods of data transmission. One is called as a routing and the other is called as a flooding. When data is routed, The nodes use logic to determine the shortest distance from the source to the destination. When we are deciding to route it, the network will automatically find the shortest route to reach from system A to B, which intends to share the information. When data is flooded, the information is sent to all the nodes within the network without the need for routing logic. When there is a need of sharing information with all the systems in the network, we can go for a flooding. But when there is an logical sharing required, that is from A to B or A to C or A to D, in that cases, we have to go for a routing. Let's talk about hybrid topology. Hybrid topologies combines two or more different topology structures. The tree topology is a very good example integrating the bus and star layouts. Mostly found in larger companies where individual departments have personalized network topologies adapted to suit their needs and network usage. Hybrid structures has got the degree of flexibility they provide as there are few limitations on the network structure itself that a hybrid setup cannot accommodate. So it is most flexible among all the other networks. That's why most of the companies prefer to go for a hybrid topology. Thank you.